So, it's been kind of an interesting week for the Rams. It's but well, just a quick little rewind. The Rams went ahead and they were on a three-game losing streak, as we all know. They didn't win a game in November. They looked a little lost. It was looking pretty rough. They got things together last week against Jacksonville, kind of switched things up, both philosophically and schematically, which was good. And the question was, were they going to build on it? Were they going to build on what getting back on track last week? In this game, which we were playing the Arizona Cardinals, who some people believe are the best team in the NFL right now. I believe at the beginning of the game they had the best record in the league, 10-2. Looked to be a lock to win the NFC West. They were at home. It was a big challenge for us. Definitely a big challenge. They've earned that record. They're a very good team. And so we're thinking, okay, how are we going to build on this? How are we going to build on this? From how are we going to build from last week's win at with Jacksonville? Well, the week didn't start off great. We had a few people who were injured. Brian Allen was going to miss some time. Darrell Henderson looked like he was going to miss some time. And then some craziness happened, as you can see on the screen here. We had some guys get COVID, get put on the COVID list. Darrell got put on the list. Let's see, Dante Dion, one of our starting defensive backs, got put on the list. Darrell, like I said, got put on the list. Rob Havenstein, our starting right tackle, got put on the list. Oh Lord, it's let me think. We had one more. Forget who it was. But anyway, with mere hours before the game started, this showed up, and you can just go ahead and add our star defensive back Jalen Ramsey and Tyler, our tight end Tyler Higbee, were put on COVID-19 reserve as well. So, definitely not a good start. Yeah, it was Darrell Henderson, Rob Havenstein, Dante Dion were put on the list. And it just it you know the whole thing just seemed kind of strange. It was just I don't know, the timing of it just didn't it just seemed a little strange, and I'm gonna keep it at that. But it just seemed a little strange. And well, so we had to go in there with a bunch of our backups in the secondary, especially. And with Robert Rochelle being out, that's who it was. Robert Rochelle being out, Dion and Jalen. And it just was not looking good. And well, with all of that, as you can see here, even with us being shorthanded, the Rams stunned the Arizona Cardinals with a final score of 30-23. So, despite being short a bunch of players mere hours before the game started, having our star defensive back and a bunch of our starters being pulled from us, seemingly right before the game started, we still came into Arizona and whooped y'all. And whooped y'all. 30-23 in a game where the Rams looked so good, dude. I really liked the offense, how they built on what happened last week with Jacksonville. They continued the physical play. They continued the jumbo, the six lineman jumbo sets. They continued running the football. Matthew Stafford looked incredible tonight. Matthew was on point. He was making these crisp bullet passes that were right on the money, almost the entire night. That is something I have not seen from him in quite a few weeks now. He had a couple of killer throws to Van Jefferson. Odell looked great. Odell played really smart today too. And Sony, my man, Sony, dude. Sony was slamming these dudes in the mouth and pushing the pile forward. There was one play where it was like a crucial third and one in the beginning part of the game, and it was all Sony. I didn't see a Rams lineman around him. He literally gets swallowed up, and he somehow still pushes his way for a first down. I was cheering, dude. And Stafford like bombed it to Van Jefferson, dude. It was so crazy. It was so crazy. And the defense, bro, dude, the defense, despite having a bunch of backup defensive backs, we held off Kyler Murray for most of the game. We got so many picks in this game, dude. Hold on. Let me see if I can find it in here. Where is it? On the road, man. I could not believe it. And it just seemed like, and despite, and by the way, the referees, they seem to be loving Arizona, man. There was, Matthew got laid out and got smacked in the head, didn't throw a flag. He got grabbed by his face mask, didn't throw a flag. They never throw the flags for us, man. Like whenever our quarterbacks get beamed in the head, it just seems like the refs don't ever call that. I mean, last year in the divisional round, John Wolford nearly got his head taken off by a cheap shot by Jamal Adams. That put him in the hospital, mind you. A game in which Jared Goff came in with a broken thumb and still knocked him out of the playoffs. That was pretty sweet. But it just, we don't ever get those calls. I don't know what the deal is, man. It's... That got me so hot, the face mask and seeing Matthew gets beamed in the head, and the refs just didn't even, the announcers were like, oh, the refs can't see it because he's the tackles and the guards in the way. I'm like, I mean, that's not my problem. It's your job to see that. It was blatantly, the guy blatantly grabbed his face mask. It was crazy. But anyway, despite that, like, we picked this dude off so many times. It was nuts. God, and the defense looks so... And, yo, Greg Gaines. Greg Gaines is an athlete, bro. Like, he chased down Kyler Murray multiple times in this game, where had he not done that, Kyler would have broken free for a big gain, like a big run gain, multiple times throughout this matchup. Yo... Gaines is an athlete. Gaines looks so good. Who else? Darius Williams also played really well. He really stood up and locked down Hopkins. Like, here's what's crazy. Hopkins really didn't do anything on us. Even with our best defensive back out and a lot of our secondary defensive backs, we really had, like, practice squad people in there. Like, Orr was in there for a little bit. I saw him like fall on a play. He like, I guess, just tripped over himself. You know, that's it. You know, it's to be expected that he's a practice squad player for a reason, you know. So, but I mean, and we still held these dudes, man. It was crazy. But special teams is an F, dude. Like, the end of the game, that the Cardinals actually kicked a field goal, kicked an onside kick, and got it, dude. They actually got it. And so it was an exciting last minute of the game. And our special teams is so awful. If there's one criticism of the game, bro, we need to somehow, some way, the special teams has got to get better. Because they are so awful right now. I'm sorry, guys. Y'all are so awful. There is no way they should have gotten that onside kick. And what's crazy is I really felt scared because I felt like they might get it, because I'm like, man, our special teams, I don't know, man, we've been looking kind of shaky. And sure enough, they actually got it. But other than that, dude, I mean, congratulations, boys. I mean, I'm going to give y'all a round of applause. I'm going to give a round of applause to Sean. Sean, I thought you called a really good game. You built on the adjustments you started last week against Jacksonville. Continued to run a more simpler power run. Well, not necessarily power run, but more more physical brand of football. Kind of mixed it up. The rhythm and the timing I thought was a lot better. Like you picked and choose. Like you knew, like you ran the ball well when you had to, and then you picked good times to bomb it deep, and Stafford was able to deliver, like to Odell and to Kupp. Dude, Kupp went crazy this game, dude. Kupp is a gem, dude. Cooper Kupp is such a gem for this team. And Stafford, like, threw one of the craziest bullet passes I've seen in a long time. Like, at the corner of the end zone, he just, like, threw it to the ground. And the Arizona Cardinal guy was all over Kupp. And it didn't even look like he caught it, but he somehow caught it, guys. Like, Kupp somehow caught that. And Stafford threw it perfectly. It was a thing of beauty. I'm like, this is what... this makes me okay with giving up two first-round picks. This type of performance. This type of... it's really late. I've been drinking. But this type of performance, like, this is what I've been wanting to see. Like, against a quality team, I don't even care about the picks if we can play like this every week. The team looks so good. Aaron Donald, I got to give Aaron Donald a shout out. He, like, started the game with a sack and ended ended the game with a sack. Look at that. Yo, he still got it, yo. Yo, our D-line looks so good. We contained Kyler. For most of the game, he got out a few times, but that's to be expected. He's really good, but God, this team looks so good, man. I mean, congratulations to Sean. Congratulations to the players, to the backup players specifically, who had to come in on a real, real short notice and played pretty well, considering a lot of people consider Arizona the best team in the NFL right now. And we just went into their place where the refs weren't calling, you know, the refs seemed to be favoring Arizona a little bit, where we were down some starters, where the ESPN, they were all feeling the Cardinals. It was a Cardinals love fest in the pregame, let me tell you. And we still went in there and whooped them, dude. That place was sold out, man, and they were quiet for most of the night. It was a thing. It was lovely. It was absolutely lovely. I'm gonna cut it off here. I'll talk more about this. This was good. This was a good sign. Congratulations, boys. Congratulations. Y'all need to build on this. Keep building the physical style of football. I've been screaming about this since this channel was conceived, that the Rams need to be more physical. In the past 2 weeks, they have, and it's showing. It's showing. You know, you soften them up, and then you use the talent that we have to kind of blow the doors off them. But awesome job. Congratulations, boys. Congratulations, Sean. Congratulations, Raheem. Congratulations, Matthew. Congratulations, Cooper. All of you. Congratulations, Aaron. This was awesome. This was so awesome. Enjoy this. Enjoy this. Jalen, if you're probably back in LA by now, dude. Go out to the bar. Get an early start. Because this was a good win. You boys enjoy yourself. Don't do anything stupid. Go have fun. Come back to work. And let's get ready for, I think I want to say Seattle. I think it's Seattle. So another big game. We got to get right back to work. So congratulations. Enjoy yourselves. This was big, and I'm proud of you. I'm proud of all of you. Proud of all the coaches. Proud of all the players. Proud of the fight that you shown tonight. Excellent, excellent job. All right, that's going to be it for now, guys. I'll catch you guys on the next one. And as always, go Rams.